Hello and welcome back to the channel. For those who are returning, thank you ever so much. And for those who have subscribed already, you know, really appreciate it. I know we're in early days, low numbers, but at least you guys will get to see these videos first. For those just tuning in, please check out the last restoration video. We have a lot more of them coming up in the coming year, plus a lot of unboxings. And other things which fit in with the hobby, really. So, you know, for this video, I thought we'd just do an unboxing on one of the original Johan 1965 Cadillacs. I believe this was a tool which was used for 2 years, between 1965 for the coupe and the convertible, and then it was the tooling was modified to the 1966 for the coupe and convertible, and I think that was the end of the line for this actual tooling. I do have a 66 as well, but I thought we'd just maybe run a little bit of a series and go through the ones which I have actually got. I mean, I think after 66 there was a new tool for the 67 convertible and hardtop coupe, which was then retooled for the 68, and you know, that tooling carried on to through 69 and 70, but only for the hardtop. That and the convertible tooling for the 68 was left alone, hence why you'd seen it repop in the late 70s, early 80s as the Bossman kit. But you know, we'll try and run through a few of them. I mean, I've not got all of them, but we've got a few of them, whether they're in like minting box like this one or whether they're builders. Yeah, maybe a little bit of the series ahead of us, but yeah, we're going to start off on this one. I think this is a pretty much minting box kit. It's the second 65 Cadillac I bought. I originally bought a builder, which we'll have a look at a little bit later. I did want to build one of them as the one of the cars out of the original gone in 60 seconds. I've got one sort of signposted to be Billy's Lowrider, but yeah, just a really nice, these are just really nice old kits, and I thought, you know, rather than them sitting on the shelf and collecting dust and not having anything done with them in the meantime, you know, may as well share them with you guys. So we'll start looking at the box art on this one. Top of the box, just really nice art rendering of that 65 coupe. I don't know if that was originally an advertisement picture they'd taken, but and below is the custom version. I think these were pretty much labelled as two in ones. It was stock and custom with maybe the exception of a few racing parts if you ever wanted to make a racing one out of these. But yeah, I'm not too sure who ended up doing the designs for Johan for the customizing parts like AMT and MPC. Had certain big names I aren't clued up at all who did design for any of the custom work or artwork on these boxes. But yeah, this is obviously a flat box kit, as most of them were back in this era. I think they ran flat boxes up to sort of 69 or 70 maybe, but I think you started seeing the change in the boxes in sort of 69, I would have thought. But yeah, box is okay. Got a little bit of damage here and there, but you know, still display well on the shelf. It's been quite well looked after, this one. But yeah, we'll just go have a look for some of the options here. Obviously the other run of kits for 65 listed there. This side we've got obviously custom seat, center console, interior tub. Then you're just going really through the standard parts you would accept in a kit. You know, they're making quite a big deal out of valve covers and exhaust manifolds. But I suppose we're only, when this kit came out, we're only 5 years on from when you were literally getting promos in a box with a few extra customizing pieces. Maybe that's why they were shouting about having valve covers and a carburetor and what have you. On the other side, typical Johan tyres, always for the most part white banded. These always had posable front steering with a steering rack, custom wheels, headlamps, fender skirts. All these nice customizing pieces. I know they're not to everybody's taste, and I probably wouldn't use them on an actual 65 Cadillac. There are other options you can use these parts on without using an original kit. So, but I think what I'll do, because like most of my kits, they're all, as soon as I buy them, nothing goes on the shelf until I've bagged all the parts separately and photographed everything, so I have everything, you know, on file, so to speak, so I don't necessarily have to dig through boxes, which sometimes aren't really accessible. But yeah, what I'll do is I'll get this all taken out, laid out on the bench, and then we can have a proper look at it rather than me scrabbling through bags to get to each part. So yeah, I'll get all these out of the packaging added, and we'll see you in a second. Right then, well, that's all the parts taken out, or pretty much taken out. Left a few little bits in the bags just because I really don't want to get involved in potentially losing those or having to rebag them all over again. But yeah, like I said, this was a pretty much untouched kit. I think the only thing that has actually been started on it is the engine has been glued together. But, you know, there's so much nice detail on these Johan engine blocks. I mean, like I said, a lot of people say that, you know, they weren't great kits, but when they did put the detail in, you know, they really did make an effort on those little finer details where you wouldn't really expect it on a kit of that age. But yeah, I think that's the only thing that's really been put together on that one. Rest of the parts are either mildly loose or falling off, or, you know, still on the sprue, luckily. But yeah, we just got the top of the engine block there, the manifolds, radiator, what looks to be the chassis plate suspension lowering tabs, and pins for the chassis and interior tub. It's unusual not to see screws in these, but they obviously weren't using screws. They've gone straight to pins on by 1965 for this particular one anyway. On this one, just got pulley and fan belt assembly, battery, again with really nice fine engraving, just wheel backs. That's one of the hubs for the front posable suspension, and centre console. That's just the other part, that's the other wheel hub there. Just got a centre console there. Again, if we can get that to focus, yeah, we've really like nice detail to the, I'm assuming that's an 8-track in the middle there and a clock and what have you. On here we've just got some lap belts and some other bits and pieces, not too sure what they are. Seats, you have a choice of the stock seats, nice engraving for the 65 interior pattern. and they've actually been the glue back backs are being glued to those as well. So again, nothing too major, and I am too fussed about mink kits anyway, to be quite honest with you. Once I start seeing glue on stuff, it just makes me want to build it more. So custom seats, yeah, really nice contour to them. Certainly have your legs stretched out on those, if you had those in your car. But yeah, just a nice little option. So for body panels, you got these really long side skirts. I mean, I'm not a massive fan of side skirts, to be fair. Whether it's custom or not, it's I used to love them. I used to put them on everything when I was younger, but you kind of grow out of sort of phases, and I do prefer, whether it's Cadillac or whatever, to have open wheel arches. So yeah, a couple of them. Just a rear custom panel. It doesn't really show much in here because you've got a lot of chrome inserts to go into that. So it's basically a rolled pan. Fits into the back, and then your custom rear bumper fits over there. Custom front end. I think this was 65 only. I think they changed the custom front end for 66, but that's probably to do with the extra space needed for, because they deleted that grill, sort of side grill insert above the front bumper. So, but I mean, say the styling parts, they do fit really well. Like I say, you wouldn't probably use these on a Joanne kit, but there are other options. You can sort of use these old parts if you just come across the parts and nothing else. Interior tub. Again, it's the stock engraving on the rear seats. Really nice detail on the side panels. It's struggling to pick it up, but you know, really nice deep armrests and what have you on there. Quite a lot of detail to pick out. Textured carpet in there. Pretty much as with any 60s interior stuff, you know, pretty much straightforward. The glass on this one is really not nice, to be fair. I mean, there are a few scratches in the corner. Easy sand polish job that to get that back, but yeah, no cracks anywhere in that one. Really clear glass, really clear. The tires, like I say, some of these bits I'm just not going to take out. It's just like the small bits, which, yeah, it's the first when I first got a kit, and before, like I say, I put it on the shelf, the first things I look for is rear, the lights and things like axles and tires. Yeah, then you get a good understanding of what you're missing, and if you're missing a tail light, then it can scupper your whole build. So yeah, just one rear axle for this one, just because, you know, it's got opposable front steering. Even the tires are in really nice. I'm not taking them out, but your typical Joanne white band cross plies. Again, pretty much like new. Chrome tree has stood really well up to time. The chrome is pretty much immaculate on this one. You've got your custom rear tail light panel, custom front grille, which resembles a sort of 65 Buick Riviera type grille. They're all your lower suspension parts for the front, molded in chrome with the link bar in there. Chrome fan blade. Looks like a chrome distributor there as well. chrome steering wheel, chrome air cleaner, your nice Cadillac engraved chrome valve covers. You know, you see them in the 66 Hertz as well. Some knockoffs for the wire wheels, stock wheels there, again commonly seen in the 66 Hertz and ambulance, and the stock rear tail light assembly. Again, yeah, the chrome's really bright. I'd say really bright, but you know, the quality there, you can see it is a little bit hazy, and that's probably as it was back in the day when it was brand new. I think the only part which came off the chrome tree was the grille, the stock grille. Looks a little bit faded on the bottom and what have you, but I don't think that warrants being re-chromed. I think you could use that on any nice new build. But again, really nice engraving in that. Cadillac emblem's nice and crisp in there. The chassis, yeah, like I say, you got your posable front steering on there. That'll be where your multiple suspension height blocks go in. But yeah, just a pretty basic chassis. But you know, for Joanne, they were moving on with so, you know, in 1960, they were pretty much just a flat slab of plastic under there. So you can see they were evolving into putting a bit more time into detail. Now the main body. I mean, Joanne's always renowned for the nice bodies, and yeah, I don't think this one's an exception. It's really cleanly cast. All the scripts are nice and proud out there, so it won't be a problem detailing that. It has got a removable hood, with it not being a curbside, so yeah, you got your radiator support in there. But yeah, just a really, really nice kit, to be quite honest. You know, it's like I say, I don't have ever have the intention of having a kit where I haven't got an idea for it, but you know, other things get in the way, don't they? So it'll just be on the back burner until that time comes. I think, yeah, just a quick look at the hood. Yeah, again, we've got nice engraving on the front, all your heat shields and what have you underneath. Yeah, it's, yeah, just a really nice kit is that one, to be fair. We'll just have a quick look at the deep there, not decals, in decals instructions. Again, that nice artwork carried on into the instructions. You looks like they've got somebody else to do the artwork for that particular one, but yeah, even the instructions aren't too bad, and surprisingly, I do actually have decals with this as well. So long past being able to be used, but you know, if you've not seen one of these, then yeah, they did come with decals, and yeah, that's probably the decal sheet you would have got in yours in 1965. So yeah, I think they're past the best, but it's good to have with the kit, to be quite honest. But yeah, it'll just be your typical Joanne instruction layout, just going through the stages. Come back, just your options for the stock or custom. So I don't think they even bothered ever putting any racing parts in this. I think they knew that there was not a market for, and it was pointless spending the extra money on tooling for racing parts where they knew nobody would ever build something like this as a stock car or anything. think the only things we haven't really looked at is yeah, the tail lights. Thought we were missing a tail light there, but there's just one loose in the bottom. So you got stock and custom tail lights, all very washed out. As you can see, you know, there's barely any red left on that, but very patchy. But I don't know if that was how they were manufactured or if that's just worn off in time. But yeah, like I said, the first thing I look for in a box after I bought a kit is, yeah, make sure them tail lights are there, because you're pretty much scuppered, aren't you, if you don't find them. And just the headlamps, I think those look like they're all still mounted on the sprue. I'm assuming the two bottom ones are for custom and the top ones are for the stock version. But yeah, I mean, that's pretty much it. I mean, what I'll do is I will take some pictures of individual parts. I've already got some on my computer, so I'll either use them or just take ones off the phone now, just because it'll be a lot easier. But before we close this off, I've got a builder. I might as well show you at the same time, and then we'll close this video off. So yeah, I thought if we're doing these videos, and I've got something else in the collection which relates to that subject we're covering, I would include it in the same video rather than doing a completely different video on just what can be old built-ups. But yeah, I thought also that kind of gives the viewer it gives you more of an idea of what these look like when they were built up, as opposed to just parts in a box. So wherever I can do that, I will. But yeah, I bought this one off eBay about maybe 3 or 4 years ago. They don't really come up that often. I've only seen 265s come up, and I think I probably bought both of them. But yeah, this is just a nice old build, and like I say, it does give you a look at how these built up back in the day, and you know, it's and a better look at that kind of how everything works all together. But yeah, this is quite a nice. I feel bad about restoring this one, maybe, just because you can tell it wasn't a bad looking model back in the day. But it is starting to show signs of wear. This one, you know, chips to the paint, and you know, the boot. Trunk lid sinking around the screw post there, and it's just starting to look a little bit tired. I wouldn't be against restoring this, put it that way. I know a lot of people would just buy that and put it on the shelf as a survivor, but I'm a little bit ruthless when it comes to survivors. You know, they have to be really nice for me not to tear into them, unfortunately. So that might upset a few people, but yeah, that's just me, I'm afraid. So but yeah, just a look at that ice grill there. Distinctive 1 year only side grills in the top of the bumper. I haven't got any convertibles of the 65 at all. I haven't really gone out of my way to look for one, to be quite honest with you. I prefer the coupes, and like I say, I was going to build this one into the Gone in 60 Seconds Billy car, so I needed a hardtop anyway. But yeah, even on this one, the chrome's not too bad. Starting to dull off, but it's certainly not rubbing off as much as I've seen on other old kits of the era. So yeah, this one's quite nice. You know, you've got the added first aid box, the record player inside. Looks like they painted it black and purple. It's hard to get the camera to focus in there, but you know, it's yeah, really clean builder is this one. You can see that posable front suspension. The tie rod's snapped in half, unfortunately, but that'll be an easy repair. I do think this paint looks really washed out. It's so you see the original colour around there, but yeah, I think the sun's got to this one, and yeah, you can see under the bonnet where that was the original kind of finish, which has been protected by the sun. But even there, you can just see that nice Delco engraving on the top of the battery we looked at earlier, and the grab handle on the battery, and the nice engraving to the valve covers. But yeah, I thought I'd just include that one. Then you get a good sort of overall view of how these look at these old kits. Yeah, I think we'll wrap this one up. If you've enjoyed the video, please like, share and subscribe. I've got a lot more ideas, you know, of things we can do with the channel between the restorations. Like I said in the list, if you haven't watched my last video, please go and watch that. I know it's a long one, but you know, it's that 644 came out quite nice, and we'll be doing a lot more of them, but they'll take 2 to 3 weeks, I think, and you know, we'll have more stuff like this in the meantime. So yeah, please like, share and subscribe, and you'll be seeing a lot more of this stuff. Okay, thanks ever so much, and see you in the next video.